Hello guys, in this quick video I'm going to add these storage spaces under the seats from my A4 B8 from 2010. Okay, so let me show you the codes for these things. If I could actually see them, yep, here it is, first code, and this is for the right side one. And I just want to tell you, this is a manual adjustment, so these codes are not valid for the electric adjustment, just for the manual one. And for the driver's seat, this is the code, as you can see, left. Again, if you have seats that adjust like this electrically, it means you do not have this. So these things will be a bit longer on this side, and what can I say, lucky, because mine are quite small. But anyway, as you probably already know, there aren't many storage spaces in the A4. So what I did until now, lifted the seat to the maximum, put it back to the maximum, and removed the covers over the screws on both sides. Maybe you can see that one there. But I didn't find a proper way to remove them. As you can see, I broke one of the covers. The other one was lucky and it actually survived, but it is a bit white there, so it was actually beginning to break. If any of you know how to properly remove the covers that go right here, please tell me, give me a link or something, and I will add that in the description of the video. I've got no idea, so I simply force them out with a screwdriver. I'm a bit tight on time at the moment, so I don't have really time to search online for this. And I just want to loosen the screws of the seat so I can put it a bit back so I can see better underneath. Because the guys that I bought these things from didn't give me any screws or anything like that, so I've got no clue how I will attach these things at the moment. To undo the seats, you need something like this. It has 12, I don't know, points or edges or ridges, whatever you want to call them, to it. And it fits quite nicely. I've done this with Inbus, but that one is hit or miss. You have a good chance of stripping the screw, so buy this thing. So yeah, I will loosen all the screws now and put the seat a bit back. Ta-da! As you can see, the seat is loose. Now I have way more room. Make sure you do not lift it too much so you break the cables for the airbag and the heating and what you have in your seat and these adjustments, whatever. And the problem is that the way I'm doing this, I have no possibility to put in this screw. This one is it's easy because it's opened up, but this one I need to take this out, so I need to undo this screw and this screw right here. And for that I'm going to use a little Torx. But I've already put the Torx in, so I'm not sure what number it actually is. It's a T10. So this thing, I will take out the front of this storage compartment, and then I have full access to it, and it will be way easier, and I see what I can come up with in terms of screws to hold it in. Just wanted to add, these things do not open up easily. I had to push with a screwdriver like this to get it out. It is out, but yeah, you really need to bend this. I cannot even show you. You really need to bend this a lot, almost to the point of you are afraid of breaking it, to get this one out of it. Inside, back, they will go easier. As you can see, they have an edge there that it will allow them to go a bit easier in, but to get them out, whoa, that's not easy at all. So you are probably better off taking the whole seat out, but yeah, I started on this route. I'm not stopping at this moment. So let's continue.
I'm really lucky. My father had something exactly the way I need. Which are these things? We have a hole there, a square one, through which I can put this in, actually the other way around, and then slide it to the on top of the round hole, and then actually a screw will go in without any issues. I will show you in a moment. I need to get some light in there so you can see what I'm talking about. Okay, let me show you underneath this seat. As you can see, I haven't fully stretched the cables, so be careful about that. And let me show you where this thing will attach. If I could actually see myself, because I cannot find them at the moment. Okay, so here is one of them, and the other is right there. And it will also attach in this hole and in this hole right here. But there you do not need any screws, it's just some plastic sliding action. So that hole there, and this hole here, and I already put one metal clip in. I will put another there, and then tighten everything back up. Yeah, it's way easier if you take out the seat. You can see here the first screw. And the second one I'm going to attempt, but not sure what I can do. Yeah, it's somewhere down there. But yeah, everything is tightened up. And next I need to put this thing back in. Let me try and move the light just a tiny bit. Maybe it helps you understand what I'm doing. This will go in like, well, like so, something, or maybe on the other side first and then on this one also. So yeah, not going to be funny, but I need to do it. And it's in, and next I just need to put back its screws from wherever I actually put them. And as you can see, the screws are back in and this is fully working. Ta-da! Yes, as you can see, this plastic is not right for the variant that has this thing on it. Probably this is only for more expensive chairs, or maybe they just changed this plastic. I've got no clue, but believe me, I don't care at all. Because if you let this sit down, that thing becomes really not that important. Don't really care about it. So, next, let's do the other side. Okay, I'm going to try and show you how I remove these things. Again, this is probably not the proper way, but this is how I do it. I managed to remove two until now without breaking one. The first one broke, but I didn't do it exactly the first two, exactly like this one. So basically I need to remove, to push it forward until it escapes. Because in the back it has something like, where is it, something like this. Come on, focus, it's not going to focus for sure. So that thing, where I'm moving my finger, that needs to get out of the hole that it's in, because it is like that in a hole. So I need to push it until it escapes up. Really hard to film and show you at the same time. So I'm going to pry on it, probably without filming, until I manage to get it out and show you how it's actually looking when it's out. Or maybe I... Yeah, it's out. And it didn't break. This is just dirt that you saw flying away. And at this point I'm just pushing like this from the side of it, and it will start to come out. Yeah, it's not easy, it might actually break. I've got no clue, this is how I do it. Let's see, did we break another one? Nope, we didn't break it. So, yep, that's how you remove them. If you have any better ways, please tell us in the comments. Who says it doesn't pay to work on your car? Yep, my car was originally from Germany. So, €0.50. Let's continue. Okay, so I undid the screws on the second storage compartment and I'm getting ready to take it apart. So as an idea, this is how I pop it out. I just push on it from beneath and you can see it's starting to lift. And yeah, not hard, extremely hard to film. Let me try and, whoa, this will not stay in place. Let me find something to put it on. Okay, now it's staying in place. If I put something from beneath, you can see I have leverage and I'm starting to move this up. And I need this to go up until it passes over the center. So yeah, that's about it. Okay, so I'm just trying to show you the other clip. So basically you have two where you put screws in and you have two that actually slide in on the sheet metal of the seat itself. So you just need to push it in and then slide it like this and it will catch on the sheet metal. Just wanted to show you that little detail. Okay, getting ready to finish this thing. So put it in the hole in this metal right here, which is the limit for the seat in the forward direction, and then press it and it's clipped. Same thing on the other side. And this thing is looking good. I will show you them better in the morning when you have a tiny bit more light. Okay, this is the next morning. I repaired this, as you can see. It's glued back together with super glue and some cloth on the inside. Then super glue on top of it. That acts almost like fiberglass or something like that. So let's put this back in. And it's clipped in place and doing its job properly. And yeah, some might say this doesn't look that nice, but yeah, it is what it is. I'm not going to bother changing this on the seat or something like that. So it depends on what kind of seat you actually have. But for me, the purpose is done. And I really like it. Let me just show you the one on the driver's side and that will be about it. As you can see, on the driver's side there is the same situation here, but who cares? I've got myself a bit of new storage in this car that almost doesn't have any compared to my previous Skoda Octavia 2. So that's about it, guys, for this video. Thank you very much for watching. Hopefully you've enjoyed it, in which case please give it a like, check out my other videos, subscribe to my channel, and see you in the next one. Bye.